The plane! The plane! Hi, Buzz.
Hi.
How do you like my new camera?
Oh, handsome, Tattoo. Very handsome.
It's my new hobby.
Oh, that's nice. There is a great deal of scenic beauty to be photographed on Fantasy Island.
I'm not into scenery, boss. I'm mostly into people. That's why that. Hold that smile. Your picture will be ready Thursday. Come see me.
How much do you charge for your photographic services, Tattoo?
Charge? Boss, why do you always have to be so mercenary?
Smiles, everyone! Smiles! Mr. Richard Delaney and his wife, Dora.
They look nice. Why are they here?
Mrs. Delaney believes it's for a second honeymoon.
But there is more.
Oh, there is indeed, Tattoo. Mr. Delaney has a much more ambitious secret fantasy he wants to accomplish.
Let me guess.
All right.
It's got something to do with beautiful women, right?
It so happens Mr. Delaney is a baseball fan, and his fantasy is one shared by millions of others. He wants to play on a major league team. For one brief, shining moment, Mr. Richard Delaney of Chicago, Illinois, wants to be a baseball superstar.
Superstar? He does not look strong enough to be a bat boy.
Martha and Walter Tate. The Tates are disenchanted with today's permissive society. Their fantasy is one shared by a lot of people. They want to find a place where morality has not broken down and the good, old-fashioned American values still prevail.
That's not going to be easy.
Nor, I'm afraid, will it be quite what Mr. and Mrs. Tate expect. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rourke, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Honey, would you excuse me just for a second? I'll be right back. Mr. Rourke? Mr. Rourke?
Oh, yes.
Listen, I know you're very busy. I don't mean to interrupt you.
Mr. Delaney, you're not interrupting at all. You want to know when your fantasy is going to begin, right? Tommy, would you come here for a moment, please?
That's Tommy Lasorda, the manager of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
It is indeed. He's here with a group of all-stars who are getting ready for a goodwill tour. Tommy, this is the pitching prospect I've been telling you about.
Oh, sure. Delano. Hey, glad to meet you.
It's Delaney. And it's certainly an honor to meet you, sir.
I'm just on my way down to the practice field. But we're playing a game this afternoon. Be glad to have you aboard.
Well, tell you the truth, Mr. Lasorda,
Mr. Delaney will be there, Tommy, and I think you're going to be very impressed with what you see.
I'm sure I will. Thanks, Mr. Rourke. See you this afternoon, Delano.
It's Delaney. That's really Tommy Lasorda.
Richard, who is that man you and Mr. Rourke are talking to?
His name is Tommy. He's a real nice guy. He just thought maybe we'd do a little fishing this afternoon. You don't mind, do you? You said you want to go to the hairdresser's.
No, I don't mind. You go ahead and have a good time. I know how much you like your fishing. Almost as much as you like your baseball.
You have asked to experience old-fashioned values. Well, before you stands a community set in the 1690s offering precisely that. And that quaint white house across from the bookbinders is your home for the weekend.
It's lovely, Mr. Rourke.
But I must give you a friendly word of caution, Mr. and Mrs. Tate. In leaving the present to enter the past, you may be giving up more than you anticipate. And receiving something that... you may not wish.
I don't think so, Mr. Rourke. But thank you for caring, though.
We're very grateful. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Let us hope that their gratitude is not premature.
You look fine.
Well, I don't know about that, girl. These shoes, they hurt my ankles. I'm gonna go back and get my sneakers.
Oh, nonsense. You'll get used to those buckle shoes. Now pull up your socks and put on your hat. We don't want our new neighbors to think my husband is behind the times.
All right. All right. Come on.
Help! Help me! Help, Prithee, help me.
What is it? Are you all right?
It was Ned. He threw me to the ground and then tried to kick me and then ran off when he's heard you coming.
No man has the right to treat any woman like that. Where did he go?
Oh, there he is, but have a care. Ned is very strong. Be thou the Tates, Walter and Martha?
Yes, but how did you know?
Because thou art strangers and we have been expecting thee to be our new smith.
Smith?
Blacksmith, sir. We have been expecting thee to tend the town forge.
I used to run my grandfather's smithy during the summertime back on the farm. Rourke. How did Rourke know that?
Rourke?
Oh, a friend of ours.
Thee'd best hurry, Mistress Proctor. Dr. Whitfield will brook no delay. And all are expected. All.
We're all expected to do what? Where?
To the town square. Everyone must attend under penalty of law. Come.
Heads up out there.
Hey, that's Steve Garvey.
And over there is Fred Lynn of the Boston Red Sox.
Come on, Garvey, let's see you get a hold of one.
Coming your way, Freddy.
And George Brett from Kansas City. And his brother, Ken Brett.
Ken Brett, he won the All-Star game a few years ago.
And Elise Valentine. He played in the All-Star game last year.
Looks like an All-Star game right now. I mean, they're all here, just like you said they would be.
I'm so glad you're pleased. Oh, you better suit up. The clubhouse is over there.
Yeah, couldn't we just watch a little while longer?
But the game is gonna start in 10 minutes.
Is something wrong, Mr. Delaney?
Yeah, actually, it's my wife, Dora. She's back at the hotel all alone, I think. Maybe we better call this off for now.
Mr. Delaney, The fantasy you requested was to pitch against some of the great players in baseball, wasn't it?
Yeah, I know it. It was.
Well?
Well, Mr. Rourke, I've wanted to be a professional baseball player all my life. I mean, dreaming about it is one thing, but actually being here, holy cow. They're going to laugh me off that mound after my first pitch.
It is said the saddest thing in the world is the loss of all the marvelous hopes and dreams that never came true because those who dreamed the dreams were afraid of the laughter of others. Here, let me give you something for good luck. It is said Sandy Koufax pitched his perfect game with his ball. Have faith in yourself, Mr. Delaney. Have faith in Fantasy Island.
Hey, Delano! Come on, let's go. We got a uniform all waiting for you. Come on, let's go, buddy. Hey, the way I got it figured, we're going to open up with Catfish Hunter. We'll go with Ken Brent, the middle three.
Right.
And if he runs out again, you're my man, Delano.
Fred Lynn, Steve Garvey, George Brett, Ellis Valentine. I think Mr. Delaney better off for him.
Sounds like everyone's having a good time.
Now, now, good people! Enough merriment! Enough merriment! Bring forth old Pew!
The man is drunk.
Aye, Mistress Tate, 'tis the third time this month.
Quiet. I pray thee quiet, so that thou mayst hear the judgment rendered this day.
Who's he?
Dr. Whitfield, chief elder of our town.
Hezekiah Pew. Thou stand accused of shameful intoxication within the public square. How say you?
Oh, guilt.
Hezekiah Pew, for thy crime, thou shalt receive 30 lashes well laid on.
Oh, nay. I pledge thee never to drink again. Now, please have mercy. Have mercy.
Take him away.
30 lashes? Walter, that's barbaric.
I can't believe they'll really do it. They'll probably just scare him and send him home.
The law must be upheld for the common good. Whosoever shall break the law will surely be punished. As newcomers, you must know that this is our way of life.
These good people are Martha and Walter Tate.
Pleased to meet you, Dr. Whitfield.
I bid thee welcome, and I admonish thee to cleave unto the law.
That man, Hezekiah Pew, is it necessary to give him 30 lashes?
Hezekiah Pew acted immorally. For this he is punished. Wilt thou come with me to my home? We shall study the scriptures together and meditate upon the evils which abound in this life.
I thank thee most heartily, but I have chores to attend to.
Chores can wait, thy soul cannot.
Doctor, sorry, but Charity is going to help us out this afternoon.
As ye wish, Mistress Proctor. At my side, I could have done this girl great good. Do not, again, meddle in my rightful affairs.
Thank thee. I had no taste for study this day.
We didn't help you avoid Dr. Whitfield without reason. We would like you to show us around.
And that I shall do with the lightest of hearts. Come.
Baker, good friend, I think we should keep close watch on our new neighbors.
Here's the second inning. Hunter stretches. Here's the pitch. The deep drive to center field. And Valentine moves to second on the play. And it's obvious that Hunter doesn't have any good stuff. Gil Stratton describing the action as Steve Garvey comes to bat with men on first and second base. And Garvey rips one down the left field line, but it is foul. It is 0-1.
Smitty all right?
I live above your shop. I pray that we shall be allowed to remain.
Of course you'll be able to remain. I think we can all be very happy here.
I am pleased. Doubly pleased that they also wish to buy my firewood. It is how I earn my bread since my husband died last winter of the fever.
Husband? But you're only a child.
Nay, mistress, I was fully 13 when I wed. I could have married 2 years earlier, but I stubbornly insisted on waiting until I knew my own mind. Dr. Whitfield wanted me to marry him, but I wouldn't have any man except Andrew Proctor. Come, let me show you your shop.
Imagine, a girl that age, already a widow.
Inside. Well, let's have a look, see at our forge. Come on. Well, it's been some time since this has been in use. Once we sweep it up, let a little light in, it'll do just fine.
Walter, there's someone in here.
Methinks I know Pumpkinhead. Ethan! Ethan Proctor, come out this instant!
Please, Mother, don't punish me with but a prank.
Oh, Charity, don't spank him. Boys will be boys.
And he is a fine-looking boy.
But I must not be permissive. I must discipline him for frivolity. Dr. Whitfield says it's lure to the devil's minions.
The best way to keep the devil away is by hard work. Now, Ethan, are you going to help me reopen the forge here?
May I tend the fire, sir?
No, first we have to sweep up.
Charity, what is it? The bell?
There has been a death. It is the undertaker's cart.
It's old Pugh, the drunk.
He perished under the lash. It is God's judgment on him for his sinful ways.
It wasn't the Almighty who used the whip. That man was beaten to death.
The law must be upheld. Or would you have had us be lenient with the breaker of the law? I ask you again to come to my house for the sake of your soul. Thou mayst prepare my evening meal.
Charity is eating with us.
Walter, Dr. Whitfield frightens me.
Hit right on the mound. He's pitched very well, but he could be tiring. There's a man on first base. Now in his fifth inning of relief for Hunter. And it's low for a ball. Ellis Valentine is the batter. Ken Brett has pitched extremely well since he came in the second inning in relief.
How about a little high fastball, Ken?
You'll be lucky to even see this pitch, Valentine.
Here's the pitch. And Valentine hits a drive to deep left center field. Going in for extra bases. All the way out to 377-foot mark. Valentine stopping at second base, carrying...
Having a good time,
Tattoo? Boss, you're missing a great game.
Really?
He's 5-4 in the ninth.
How's Mr. Delaney doing?
So far, so good. He has not played yet.
Top of the ninth inning, and there is nobody out in this Fantasy Island All-Star game. And ball three on the batter. Manager Tommy Lasorda is worried he may have...
I think Greg is getting tired. He has already pitched 5 shutout innings.
And that's ball four. He's walked him, and that fills the bases, and that brings out Lasorda.
How do you feel, Ken?
Sorry, Tommy, I'm bushed.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. You pitched 5 great innings. I'm really proud of you. Delano!
Lasorda making his pitching change.
Delano!
It's Delano.
Come on, get in here.
Check that. It's Delaney, number 37, coming into the ballgame.
Here you go, Delano.
No, thank you. I already have one.
Good luck, kid.
Now the man give Ken Brett a nice hand for his five innings of work.
You're in a tough spot, kid. You have the bases loaded, nobody out. And three of the greatest hitters in the game coming up to the plate. I know you can do it. Take all the warm-up pitches you need.
No, I don't need any.
Hey, everybody warms up.
Well, not me. I just heard him throw the ball.
He's ready.
Okay, let's play ball.
Now, Delaney must face the heart of the batting order. George Brett of the Kansas City Royals, Steve Garvey of the Los Angeles Dodgers, and Fred Lynn of the Boston Red Sox. What a spot for an unknown pitcher. This is going to be a real test for Delaney, and he's not even taking any warm-up pitches. George Brett steps in. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one!
And he swings and misses for strike one.
I'm still just warming up.
0-1 count. George Brett. Here's the pitch.
Strike two!
Hey, take a look at that ball.
What that ball was doing.
Give me the ball, Robbie. Nothing wrong with the ball, George. Play ball.
It's not a knuckleball, but it's doing all kinds of tricks up there. Look at that pitch. And it's strike three, and he struck George Brett of the Kansas City Royals out on three consecutive pitches. He's two more outs to save the game for Ken Brett. This brings Steve Garvey of the Dodgers to the plate. Boy, does he have power. Delaney's pitch. And Garvey swings and misses.
I don't believe this guy.
This is not a knuckleball. It's not a flutter ball. It's not a pooper pitch, but it's doing all kinds of tricks coming up there.
Strike two.
And Garvey swings and misses for strike two. Delaney one strike away from striking out Steve Garvey. And he's got it. He struck out Steve Garvey on three consecutive pitches. So on six pitches, he has retired George Brett and Steve Garvey. And the former MVP of the Boston Red Sox, Fred Lynn, coming to bat. Lynn will have the advantage as he's a left-handed hitter facing Delaney's right-handed slants. Certainly gained his confidence now.
Strike one!
Again, he swings and misses. Boy, I tell you, I have never seen this kind of stuff. Not even taking any warm-up pitches. Here comes the second pitch. It wiggles around, and Lynn doesn't really take a cut at it until the ball is in the catcher's mitt.
What is that guy throwing?
One strike away from retiring the side. Here it comes, and it is strike three, and Fred Lynn is out.
And I thought Nolan Ryan was tough.
He has struck out the side and won the game. An amazing pitching performance by a virtual unknown Richard Delaney.
Well, listen, you know... Thanks a lot, Ellis. Oh, hey, Mr. Rourke. Mr. Rourke, I did it. I really did it. I struck out three of the greatest players in baseball.
I'm glad you're happy.
Happy? Are you kidding? This is my dream come true. Thank you very much. Thanks, Dad, too.
Hey, Delano. Delano. Hey, you were all right out there.
It's Delaney. Delaney. Richard C. Delaney.
Sure, Delaney. I just hope I see your name on the back of a Dodger uniform this season.
What?
That's where I'm going now, to make a long-distance phone call to see if I can get somebody from the front office to come down here and see you pitch tomorrow. You can pitch tomorrow, can't you?
Oh, yeah, I guess so. But,
Hey, I gotta go now. But promise me one thing.
Yeah?
That you won't sign with anyone until you give us a chance to make an offer.
Well, sure, Tommy. Fine. I'll listen to anything you guys have to say.
Thank you. Gotta go now, kid.
Okay. Sutton, John, Rao, and Delaney. It's all right.
Good night, Ethan.
Good night, Mother.
Ethan should be asleep very soon.
Charity, Walter and I want you and Ethan to stay here until he's feeling better.
The quarters above the smithy are just too drafty.
I thank thee for making us so welcome in thy home. Ethan and I have not known such kindness of late.
Why? I should think everyone in town would like you.
I am a young widow, and as such represent temptation to the married men. Dr. Whitfield has asked me to wed him soon, lest I corrupt the community, and...
Oh, enough of this serious talk. Come on, let's have some fun. I haven't played one of these in years. Yeah, this is just like a bicycle.
What is a bicycle?
Well, something to ride. And once you learn how, you never forget. Now stop talking and start dancing. Come on.
Let's dance. Come on. See? Around. And around again. See?
What manner of blasphemy is this? When darkness falls, all good men are in quiet meditation and prayer, lest the forces of evil fall upon them.
Forces of evil? We were just having some innocent fun.
Inflaming the passions of a young widow seems to give thee pleasure.
Master Weaver is right. Thou hast been a loose woman too long for the good of this town. Thou shalt marry me on the morrow.
Nay, I love thee not, therefore I shall marry thee not.
This is thy work, Master Tate. Thou hast turned her against the town and the wisdom of the elders. For that thou shalt be punished. Take him.
Keep your hands off me!
Leave my husband alone.
Dr. Whitfield, please.
Perhaps the dunking stool will teach thee a lesson in humility. Take him to the pillory. At first light, thy punishment shall be meted out to thee.
No, let him go.
I know not from whence I came, mistress, but thy husband's actions are a crime here in Salem town.
Salem?
Do not jest with me, Master Tate. Thou knowest is Salem, Massachusetts, when thou art in it.
Salem. They burn people here at the stake.
They do, if that is the judgment Dr. Whitfield passes.
Ah, Mr. Delaney. Are you and your wife having dinner here tonight?
Well, as a matter of fact, we're just finishing up, and the food is terrific. Looks like everything else on this island.
Well, I'm glad you're having a good time. You and Mrs. Delaney must be very excited.
Well, as a matter of fact, I haven't told her yet.
You haven't told her?
No, I started to half a dozen times, but how do you convince somebody that instead of fishing, you were striking out three of the best hitters in baseball in the ninth inning with all the bases loaded?
I see your point.
Yeah, I figure if everything goes well tomorrow, then I'll tell her.
Tomorrow?
Mr. Rourke, there are things happening here that even you don't know about. Terrific things.
Indeed. Your wife is waiting for you.
I'll talk to you later.
You know, this vacation is just what you needed. I haven't seen you this happy and confident and handsome since we got out of college. Oh, there's the Maxwells.
You mean Mr. Maxwell, my boss?
Yes. Oh, I guess I forgot to tell you. They just flew in. I ran into them today out by the swimming pool. And Mr. Maxwell seemed quite pleased to discover we were here.
Why is that?
Something to do with a business meeting tomorrow afternoon.
Tomorrow afternoon is impossible.
Well, he said it wouldn't take very long, just a couple of hours.
Honey, it's not fair. We're on vacation.
But, honey, Mr. Maxwell is your boss. And we can't stay on Fantasy Island forever.
For his blasphemous crime, let punishment be delivered unto him.
Thank you.
Nay, but pray that he takes not the fever when they are finished. That is how my Andrew died.
Your husband was dead?
Aye, he kissed me in the marketplace, thinking none were about to see, and for this, Dr. Whitfield ducked him 8 times.
Oh, Walter! Are you all right?
Thank you. Probably the best T-bone I ever had.
Delaney, there you are. Been looking all over for you. Didn't your wife give you my message?
Yes, sir, she did, just before she went on the island tour.
Well, then, why didn't you come to my bungalow?
Well, I guess it's because I read somewhere that Sandy Koufax always ate a big steak before he pitched a game.
What are you talking about? Don't you realize we have important papers to go over before our meeting with the client this afternoon?
Anyone ever tell you that you're a rude man, Mr. Maxwell? That's one of the reasons why Maxwell Unlimited has never been anything more than a second-rate company. I didn't come to your bungalow because I have other things to do this afternoon.
Other things? What could be more important than our business?
Well, for starters, a baseball game.
Baseball?
And for finishers, telling you what I think of you. I'm feeling like a man again.
Delaney? You walk out on me now and you can keep right on walking because you won't have a job anymore.
You know something? That's the other thing wrong with the way you run Maxwell Unlimited. You're always so damn predictable.
How long have I been sleeping?
Most of the day. How do you feel?
Oh, soggy and sore all over. Oh, for a nice hot shower and a cup of coffee in front of our TV set.
I'm beginning to miss our lifestyle, too.
Well, it's too late to think about that now. We've got our fantasy and we'll have to stick with it until the weekend is over. And besides, Charity's gonna need our help.
She's been very worried about you, too.
Oh, Martha. We can't let that Whitfield character get his hooks into...
Ethan, he has the fever. Oh. It is the way his father began. Chills and aches.
Come on.
Sneezing, then that evil fever.
Ed, just sit down.
Nothing to worry about, Charity. Martha used to be a nurse's aide. She knows what she's doing.
His pulse is fine. His glands are... barely swollen. He just has a touch of a fever. I think it's just a little flu.
Nay, my son has taken fever and must be treated or he will die like his father. I must get Dr. Whitfield to tend him.
It isn't necessary, Charity. Ethan will be fine.
He probably just has an allergy. That and a touch of flu will... Charity.
Well, maybe she'll think it over before she finds Whitfield.
I hope so. Get me a dip of water, will you, dear? Always teasing me about carrying my drugstore around with me. But a couple of aspirin and an antihistamine ought to do the trick.
Well,
the boy.
Swallow that pill.
One more.
Yeah.
For the Los Angeles Dodgers, that new pitching sensation, Richard Delaney.
Mister?
Yeah?
When's the game start?
Oh, it's not going to start for about an hour yet. I just wanted to come out early.
You wanted the All-Stars?
Oh, no, not exactly. I'm sort of trying out today. I'm a pitcher. Did pretty good yesterday.
Can I warm you up? I got a catcher's mitt.
I usually don't warm up. Well, okay, go ahead. Ready?
Ooh. you gonna be a pitcher?
Well, I'm sorry. That one sort of got away from me.
I bet you can't strike me out.
Don't be silly.
She's pretty good. What's the matter? You afraid, mister?
Of course I'm not afraid.
Then let me try. I told you I was pretty good, mister.
Try again. She probably just got lucky.
Yeah. Pretty lucky.
Mr. Delaney.
It's over, isn't it?
Mr. Delaney, your fantasy was to pitch against some of the greatest players in baseball. Now, isn't that what you did yesterday?
Yes. But my boss, what I told my boss...
Yes, I know, Mr. Delaney. And I'm sorry. I'm very sorry.
I don't get it, boss.
What?
How can you let this happen, boss? He's such a nice man.
Let what happen to two?
Oh, Mr. Delaney. His whole life has been turned inside out. He even lost his job.
So it would appear. But remember, Tatu, this is Fantasy Island.
Stand aside. Let me minister unto the lad. Be bled and purged until the vapors which infect his spirit are drained away.
What are you doing, Whitfield? What's in that pot?
Those are leeches, sir. What dost thou expect?
To suck the poison from his veins and bring him rest.
He doesn't need you, your leeches, or your purges. His fever's broken.
'Tis truth, the fever is no more.
Then thou hast employed satanic means to take the fever from his body. Stand now before thy accuser, Thomas Goodfriend.
Sir!
Tell him what thou hast witnessed.
With mine eyes, sir, did I see this woman and man deliver strange potions unto the lad with many incantations and supplications to the devil.
That's a lie.
I only gave him aspirin and...
Here, sir, are the tools of Satan.
What is this? The evidence is overwhelming. Martha and Walter Tate... Thou hast been found guilty of being servants of Satan. A witch and a consort come to this town to destroy our piety and safety. And for that crime, I sentence thee to be burnt at the stake at the rise of the sun. And may God have mercy on thy soul.
That's it. You call in Rourke right now. Tell him to stop this thing.
I know none such as Rourke. Is that another name for Beelzebub? Or the familiar spirit you use to communicate thy wishes to thy dark master? Take them away.
You're so quiet tonight, honey. There must be something wrong. I can always tell.
No, it's okay, honey. I just have a little headache, that's all.
You see, I always know when there's something.
Hello, Delaney.
Mr. Maxwell?
I would like to apologize.
Apologize.
I've been thinking about what you said about the company. I am gruff and perhaps too predictable. But until today, I didn't know I had anyone in my company with guts enough to tell me. I would like for you to come by my bungalow tomorrow so we can discuss your future with the company. And believe me, son, you have one.
Thanks.
Yes.
Well, what was that all about?
It's nothing, dear. But this sure is Fantasy Island.
Oh,
glad to be able to touch your hand, but I can't reach it.
Oh, Walter, I can't believe this is actually happening. Do you believe they're really going to burn us?
Don't think about it, Martha.
I don't know, Walter. I'm not very brave.
You are, honey. Of course you are. Shh. What's that?
Hey, Mistress Quickly. What brings thee here?
Oh, I missed thee, Thomas, when thou didst not come to the tavern this evening. So I came to see thee.
Oh, thou camest to me. So thou missed thy revels, my love. Well, let's be at it, my dove.
But we best move out, in case Dr. Whitfield might be about. He might see us.
Charity, you shouldn't be here.
Hush, speak not, lest thou give us away.
I paid Mistress Quickly to distract Master Goodfriend so that I might free thee. Now go, run for thy lives.
Come with us.
Charity, you can't stay here and let Whitfield force you into marriage.
I promise thee it will not happen. I shall love and remember thee. Now go, run, I pray thee.
We'll love and remember you too, Charity. Thank you.
Stop, prisoner! Stop! Have escaped!
They must not escape to work for the satanic eagle. Kill them on sight. Kill them!
Jungle behind our house, the place that Rourke dropped us off. If we can just get to it. Now, come on, honey, try.
The witches! There they are!
After them! Now we have them! We get them! Kill them!
Mrs. Tate, how good to see you again. Did you find the perfect morality and simple life you longed for so very much?
No. We found nothing but ignorance and intolerance.
And a monstrous man who traded on fear to rule the people.
Really? My, my. How much that sounds like our present world. How much that sounds like any century in which man has ever lived. Perhaps that is a very good lesson to be learned. But later, after you've freshened up, I must say you do look exhausted. After you.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Delaney, I hope you have been satisfied in your visit here.
More than my wildest dreams. You didn't just give me one fantasy, you gave me two.
Oh, no, no, if you're referring to the new understanding you have with your boss, well, that was entirely your own doing.
Mr. Rourke, coming here was just what Richard needed. Just to relax and do nothing, no excitement. It was just the therapy he needed. I haven't seen him this relaxed in years.
I am so happy we were able to provide the tranquility necessary. Have a very pleasant trip home.
Thank you very much.
Very welcome.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Delaney. Goodbye.
Thank you for our fantasy, Mr. Rock. We've both learned something very important.
Living without indoor plumbing is not easy.
No, but every age has its difficulties. You see, running away certainly isn't the answer. All ages, past, present, or future, there's nowhere to run to.
Goodbye.
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 Bye-bye. Have a pleasant trip.
Bye-bye.
Aquí, come here. Stand there. Smile, honey.
No, 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 wait, Abdul, wait.
What's wrong?
Well, you can't take pictures with this on.
What's that?
The lens cap. How long has it been on your camera?
Since I bought it.
Then all the film you shot has been wasted.
Film? Who's using film?
Smile for you.